Aesop's Fables. Mercury and the Woodman. A woodman was felling a tree on the bank of a river, when his axe, glancing off the trunk, flew out of his hands and fell into the water. As he stood by the water's edge, lamenting his loss, Mercury appeared and asked him the reason for his grief, and on learning what had happened, out of pity for his distress, he dived into the river and, bringing up a golden axe, asked him if that was the one he had lost. The woodman replied that it was not, and Mercury then dived a second time, and, bringing up a silver axe, asked if that was his. "No, that is not mine either," said the woodman. Once more Mercury dived into the river and brought up the missing axe. The woodman was overjoyed at recovering his property, and thanked his benefactor warmly, and the latter was so pleased with his honesty that he made him a present of the other two axes. When the woodman told the story to his companions, one of these was filled with envy of his good fortune, and determined to try his luck for himself. So he went and began to fell a tree at the edge of the river, and presently contrived to let his axe drop into the water. Mercury appeared as before, and, on learning that his axe had fallen in, he dived and brought up a golden axe, as he had done on the previous occasion. Without waiting to be asked whether it was his or not, the fellow cried, "That's mine, that's mine!" and stretched out his hand eagerly for the prize. But Mercury was so disgusted at his dishonesty that he not only declined to give him the golden axe, but also refused to recover for him the one he had let fall into the stream. Honesty is the best policy. End of Mercury and the Woodman.
Aesop's Fables. The Apes and the Two Travelers. Two men were traveling together, one of whom never spoke the truth, whereas the other never told a lie. And they came in the course of their travels to the land of apes. The king of the apes, hearing of their arrival, ordered them to be brought before him, and by way of impressing them with his magnificence, he received them sitting on a throne, while the apes, his subjects, were ranged in long rows on either side of him. When the travelers came into his presence, he asked them what they thought of him as a king. The lying traveler said, "Sir, everyone must see that you are the most noble and mighty monarch." "And what do you think of my subjects?" continued the king. "They," said the traveler, "are in every way worthy of their royal master." The ape was so delighted with his answer that he gave him a very handsome present. The other traveler thought that if his companion was rewarded so splendidly for telling a lie, he himself would certainly receive a still greater reward for telling the truth. So, when the ape turned to him and said, "And what, sir, is your opinion?" he replied, "I think you are a very fine ape, and all your subjects are fine apes too." The king of the apes was so enraged at his reply that he ordered him to be taken away and clawed to death. End of The Apes and the Two Travelers.
Aesop's Fable, The Ass and His Burdens. A peddler who owned an ass one day bought a quantity of salt and loaded up his beast with as much as he could bear. On the way home, the ass stumbled as he was crossing a stream and fell into the water. The salt got thoroughly wetted, and much of it melted and drained away, so that, when he got on his legs again, the ass found his load had become much less heavy. His master, however, drove him back to town and bought more salt, which he added to what remained in the panniers, and started out again. No sooner had they reached a stream than the ass lay down in it and rose, as before, with a much lighter load. But his master detected the trick, and turning back once more, bought a large number of sponges and piled them on the back of the ass. When they came to the stream, the ass again lay down, but this time, as the sponges soaked up large quantities of water, he found, when he got up on his legs, that he had a bigger burden to carry than ever.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.